We have 4 chicks this year, compared to 5 last year and 5 the year before, and the process went perfect. It couldn't have gone any better. We took the chicks out of the box around 9:15. We banded them and put them back in the box about 10:15, so it went perfect. These chicks are 20 and 21 days old today, and it is always best to band them between 20 and 25 days of age. They cannot use their feet yet. They really can't bite yet. The parents are still caring for them totally right now, and it just makes it way easier for us to take the chicks out of the nest. They're not trying to foot us or grab us or bite us or anything, and it's safer for them too, because we put them all in the same crate, and they're, if they're all, you know, not trying to hurt each other in the crate, which they sometimes do just because they're so freaked out about the whole process, then it's even better for them. It's very safe for them, very safe for us. So 21 days of age, they were banded today. The males will fledge or take their first flight around 45 days of age, and there were 3 males today that we banded, and the females take their first flight around 55 days of age, and we banded one this morning. Yeah, we put 2 bands on each, one on each leg for these peregrine falcons. One is a U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service band, and all of those bands, I turn in my banding reports every year, and I that's their official marker, that bird's official marker. And then the other band has got a series of numbers and letters on it that are larger, that are easily seen from a further distance. So we get more band returns, so we can tell where the birds are from, where they were, of course, where they are seen, where the band is read, and we get to know that information. The more information we know about any species that we monitor so closely, the better it's going to be for us helping to save them. The fact that we have a camera up there looking at this stuff, it's just amazing. We get to see incredibly cool stuff that most people don't get to see.